Welcome to The MacGuffin, episode 278. I'm Spencer.
I'm Greg.
Today we're going to give you our DVD rundown for the week of October 1st.
We are already into October, Spencer.
We're already into October.
Welcome, fall. Well, not technically, but kind of.
Yes, right.
September 22nd?
Yeah. Something like that.
Woo! Yeah, I know my seasons. Yeah.
Seasons greetings, then, whatever.
Yeah,
it is.
There you go. Seasons greetings from MacGuffin.
Yeah. in terms of items this week, you know, it's a decent week. I wouldn't say,
it's a strange week.
A strange collection,
yes,
yeah.
Yes.
Some decent special features, some underwhelming releases, but overall, a pretty decent week.
Yeah.
The first one I want to talk about is probably the biggest moneymaker of the recent films.
Yes.
And that is The Croods.
Yeah, I think it was like sixth top grossing for the year or something like that. It saved DreamWorks. They were going to...
Yeah, DreamWorks Animation.
They were looking bad for them. It was like if this didn't succeed, they were kind of going to have to be like, we can't do this animation thing anymore.
Story of a cave family. I don't know what you're... Caveman family, whatever.
Yeah.
Who lose their home and have to trek across the...
Wilderness, I think. Yeah,
you know,
exactly.
Because I think was it Ice Age or something is coming. I forget exactly how it all plays out. I saw it. Needless to say, I think that sort of speaks to how much I enjoyed it. Made a lot of money. Made a lot of people happy.
Yeah.
Can't really fault it for that. But you know,
Was in development hell for like 8 years or 5+ years or something. Like originally had John Cleese and Aardman Animation and all these.
And
various...
so they ended up with Nick Cage.
Yep.
And Ryan Reynolds.
Ryan Reynolds, Catherine Keener, and Clark Duke in their animated film debuts, in fact.
Is it not Emma Stone's?
No.
Wow. Who knew? I would never even guess.
Yeah. I think it's probably been in one of the Ice Ages. That's my guess.
Something
I'm just
going to
toss that out
there. I'm sure somebody will correct you.
Yeah. Yes. Correct me in the comments.
But you already have, you know, the whole gamut of options. The Blu-ray 3D, the Blu-ray, the DVD digital copy. Set there in terms of special
for family film. That's, you know, you gotta kind of do that nowadays,
which is good. Blu-ray is really good with animated films, I will say that. But to note, the special features suck. There's like something called like the Crudaceous Creatures of the Croods. Find
Someone
out more
just
about
really
the...
likes alliteration.
Yeah,
that's all
I do. I do like alliteration, and even I'm not happy with this, which is just more information about the creatures in the movie.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's Be an Artist. Now you can draw Belt and Mousefint and other characters from the movie. Things like I really don't care that much about. Maybe there's somebody out there who's really big on that, but I can't imagine most people.
I'll tell you what, you include free software with your DVD or Blu-ray that lets people make animated GIFs that they can upload to the internet. Bam, I guarantee you that'll be way more popular than How to Be an Artist.
Yeah, that would be pretty popular. But you know, other than that, it's basically it. The 3D disc basically just has the movie in 3D. So
you know, why don't studios listen to us more often, Spencer?
I'll tell you what I would have liked. Nick Cage commentary.
Ooh.
How awesome with that event.
On Nick Cage, anything.
Nick
anything
Cage
he does.
And Ryan Reynolds together. Like that just right there. Like I don't even care about the movie.
I really hope that there's like someday a Nick Cage collection where he just does commentary by himself of random films of his and then releases them in a package.
Yeah.
It would be great if that could happen.
That would be awesome.
Come on, Hollywood. We're just giving you ideas to make money.
Make it happen. Probably a more critically loved, just probably audiences in general more beloved film, is the 75th anniversary release of The Wizard of Oz.
75 years, man.
75 years. I mean, how old were you when you saw this?
Jeez. I probably...
Six, five?
Probably something like that. Yeah. I probably saw it before I was too young to get it, and then saw it later as I grew up, and then finally started to get it.
I mean, this is, I mean, as classic as you can get in Hollywood.
Oh, I mean, you've got, what, number one on... Or Over the Rainbow is ranked the number one song in the greatest songs of all time by the AFI in 2004. It was named the number one greatest film in the fantasy genre by AFI, and it's the number 10 greatest movie of all time by the AFI.
And I would have to imagine The Wicked Witch of the West is on some
like
list
great
of the villain,
characters
villains
or something.
Or something.
Yeah.
Like,
it's crazy, that actress... There's a lot more stuff that they had filmed that they cut out because they deemed her too terrifying for children.
Really?
She was so scary that they were kind of like, no, I can't show all that.
But, you know, this is one of those films that's been released numerous times.
Oh,
like, they just released a 70th anniversary just 5 years ago.
Was it Warner Brothers?
Warner Brothers.
Get all them sweet ducats.
I mean, you get the Blu-ray 3D, Blu-ray, and Ultraviolet together. That's cool. There's one with, like, some extra swag and stuff like that. I don't really care about that.
Yeah.
Which costs, like, $105, which... Oof. We're not getting into that.
No, unless it has an actual flying monkey that can actually fly.
That would be awesome.
I don't care.
In terms of special features, that was everything that came before, you know, and there's tons of it, you know, making of a classic movie, a tribute to Oz, Legacy of Oz, Memories of Oz, We Haven't Met Properly, blah, 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 blah. There's like a ton of featurettes available. The only thing that's new is that there's the 3D one, and there's a new documentary called The Making of the Wonderful Wizard of Oz.
So it was like somebody was like, well, you know how we did the 70th? Well, it makes more sense to do the 75th. Can we dig one more thing out of the archives and re-release it?
Yeah, pretty much.
For 3D TVs? Yes, we can.
Yeah. So, I mean, if you haven't... Oh, and it still has the audio commentary hosted by Sidney Pollack, which I think is cool. But, yeah, I mean, if you already own it, it's really hard for me to, like, see you wanting to...
Yeah.
Get it? I mean, yeah. 3D.
Aren't they bringing it back to theaters? It already did. See, so that's probably. Oh, that's probably what this is. It's the
follow-up. To that, so, whatever. We're not going to get into that.
Yeah.
In a more amusing slash maybe cooler.
I would say cooler.
We have the complete series release of Magnum P.I.
Oh, yeah, man.
I mean, talk about like classic, iconic TV characters
classic
that
mustache.
I grew up with. Yeah, that influenced you?
Yeah. Well, I don't know, but my dad has a mustache like that, and I think I always saw the two of them as very similar.
As peers?
I think I saw my dad doing Magnum P.I. stuff on the weekends. I just assumed in my head he flew around.
Did he have
around.
A Ferrari?
No, no. And he didn't have a friend with a helicopter.
Did he live on Hawaii?
He did go to Hawaii.
That's a couple times. Almost the same. Your dad might be Magnum P.I.
He was in Vietnam, which Magnum P.I. was also in Vietnam.
Have you ever seen him in the same room as Magnum P.I.?
No, I have not.
So he might actually be Magnum P.I.
Never know. My dad might be Tom Selleck. Just putting that out there.
But this is the DVD release. There's no Blu-ray or anything. I mean, it's a DVD of a TV show from the 80s. Honestly, I don't know what it really would do for you in terms of putting it on Blu-ray. But,
yeah.
I mean,
at this point, it's just nostalgia. It's, hey, here's the whole series in one box.
I mean, they're not going to remaster 162 episodes.
That's a lot of episodes.
Yeah. Over 42 discs for the DVD release. Essentially, it's the same as all the individual season release, so all the special features, put it all together.
You know what's crazy? Because this is the kind of thing that I don't think happens very much in television anymore, for good reason. Crossovers. Did you realize that Magnum P.I. had full crossover episodes with both Simon and Simon?
I did.
And Murder, She Wrote.
And I will tell you why I knew this, because some of the special features that were on the bonus or bonus features on those previous season releases were the Simon releases. Though some of the special features were just like bonus episodes from the A-Team, and I'm like, I guess that's something, but like,
it's like Hasbro with their properties, where it's like someone has the rights to all of these, and they're just like, shove them all together.
Yeah, and so there's no new bonus content. So if you have $120, love Magnum P.I. and haven't bought any of the previous seasons, this might be for you.
If you're the kind of person who thinks a dollar an episode is not too
under
much to pay.
Dollar.
No, that's what I'm saying. If you think a dollar an episode is reasonable, you're getting a deal in this case. You're getting
and
40
Tom
free
Selleck.
Episodes, and you're getting lots of Tom Selleck.
Sexy beast right there.
Get it for your mom so that she has something to watch when your dad's not around.
Woo!
Mm-hmm.
You're going to wreck some
Respect
marriages.
Respect the stash.
Great. You're going to wreck some marriages.
So there's going to be some mustache rides coming out after this happen. Yeah, that's right. So that's right. Just put that image in your head. That's right. Simmering up here.
brings us to our final film of the week, and that is this year's one of the best comedies I saw, and that is This Is the End.
Oh man, I love
Seth Rogen, Evan Goldberg's directorial debut.
So good. In fact, I think you're wearing their official swag right now. Yeah,
got that at a CinemaCon this year.
Mm-hmm,
a little
mm-hmm.
Sony release.
Yep.
Jacket, but I mean, it's such a fun film. It's sort of, I mean, it gets all the Apatow crew together, mm-hmm, or all mm-hmm. friends in real life, and they make a fictional film about the end of the world occurring during a party at James Franco's house.
Yep, which is neat, because Evan Goldberg said he created a game for himself during filming of this movie. The goal was to get as many of the cast members as possible to say, no, I can't do that, or get them to refuse to do something. And he said that the only people that he wasn't able to break was James Franco and Seth Rogen. I mean, Seth Rogen being involved, not so surprising, but James Franco was just unbeat. You couldn't make James Franco make fun of himself.
Some of those people, like, I mean, pretty much any of them. Jonah Hill, I'm surprised you could break.
Yeah,
Craig Robinson, I'm surprised you could break.
Yeah, I guess the whole,
Danny
like,
McBride.
I mean, like, about 50% of the movie is supposed to be ad-libbed. Like, the entire Jonah Hill's response to the Milky Way, all made up on the spot, all that stuff. Another thing I really liked about it was Seth Rogen said he was shocked about how much the actors would actually insult each other while they were ad-libbing.
Oh, that's funny.
So according to him, Jonah Hill and James Franco in particular seemed to go at each other the hardest. At one point, he felt like he had to intervene, remind them that they're actually friends and do like each other.
That's funny. You know, that's sort of appropriate when you get to some of these special features. Mm. Number one, it comes out on Blu-ray, DVD, and Ultraviolet together.
Okay. It's good. Not bad.
But there are also special features like directing your friends.
Awesome.
There's, you know, party time ones, which are sort of about the party sequence at James Franco's house. There's, you know, I'm not a big deleted scene gag reel type person, but this is the kind of thing that seems very appropriate for that kind of stuff.
When you have ad-lib stuff, it's just like, and that was another thing that was neat. Jay Baruchel said he actually felt it was really cathartic for all these actors to do this because they were able to say all the stuff that maybe they didn't mean, but maybe they kind of wanted to say at some point, and they could all get it out in the open, everyone could laugh about it, then they could all pull back to like, hey, we're actually friends.
Which is good, because you also have like the short Jay and Seth versus the Apocalypse, which inspired the movie.
Yep.
And you have an audio commentary with Seth Rogen, Evan Goldberg. And the last one I want to mention is that they have outtakes from the Cannibal King sequence. If you've seen the movie, you know how awesome that sequence is.
Yes.
And there is more to it.
Yes.
With some special surprise.
I'm surprised.
Guests.
I'm surprised without giving anything away that there isn't actually a music video for this one. This is one of the few that I would actually expect a music video to have come out due to the final moments of the film.
Yeah.
It's hilarious. It's if you haven't seen it, it's really good. Probably, it's definitely easily top five comedies that I've seen in the last, God, I don't even know how many
years. Yeah. But that's it for this week. If there's other films that you want to talk about, let us know. And as always, you can find us at MacGuffin. That's MacGuff.in. We're at MacGuffinCast on Twitter, Facebook.com/MacGuffinPodcast. Phone number 323-761-9842.
Give me your digits.
We're on iTunes, Blip.tv, Miro, Roku.
You can check in and get glue to get some stickers. And you can give us some stars on iTunes and some thumbs and comments on YouTube. And we will comment back at you.
Yeah. Hit you back.
Yeah.
It's the new hit you back.
Hit you. Can we gift this? Hit you back. There you go.
You've already got one. Of you. It's probably number two.
Yes.
But we'll see you next time. Magneto can't stop me, I'm on fire tonight. Even Zod can't stop me, I'm on fire tonight. It's tight, don't even try to bite the side of the Mr. Spock can't stop me, I'm on fire tonight. The Wrath of Khan can't stop me, I'm on fire tonight. The Borg can't stop me, I'm on fire tonight. Because I've got space game and it feels alright.